I became a Christian at about age 6 or so. I don't exactly remember when, but started following Christ around that age. I got interested in dinosaurs when I was 4 years old. And almost immediately, you start to sense the tension because the books that I would bring home from the library talked about dinosaurs living 150 million years ago in the Jurassic, and dinosaurs going extinct in the Cretaceous. And yet, as I was reading the Bible, I didn't get any sense or indication that the Bible is talking about a deep, deep history to the planet. Things start with 6 days worth of creation, a Garden of Eden, two real people in Adam and Eve. And I remember being as young as 9, sitting in my playroom and trying to put these ideas together as a weird kid. But I was 9 years old and saying, well, the dinosaurs are supposed to be millions of years old, and yet the Bible gives me an age of the earth that looks like it's in thousands of years old. There's genealogies that only go back so far. So what do you do? And I remember thinking, well, maybe God made the dinosaurs beforehand, and maybe he wiped them out, and then he started with the Garden of Eden. It's kind of like a kid's version of the gap theory. Or I thought, well, maybe each one of those days of creation isn't really a day. It's some epoch, some period of time. And I didn't know then that that's kind of what's called day-age theory. So I didn't have names or deep theology that was going into this yet, but I was thinking deep theology at the time as a kid. And I came to the conclusion that the Bible's record of this was clear. Clear as could be that the earth was young, that Noah's flood was real, and therefore the dinosaurs and the other prehistoric animals that I loved so much had to fit into that young earth, and that the fossils of them must be formed somehow, and later I came to understand that that was during Noah's flood. As someone who went through 12 years of training in paleontology through secular approaches, I was trained entirely as a conventional old age geologist, even though I was a young age creationist. I worked within that system to understand it as best as I possibly could. Having a framework of understanding that starts with creation and starts with God as author of all things, perfecter of all things, and ultimately the redeemer, the savior of all things, means that as I want to live my life out, I want to do it in a way that conforms to truth. It's orienting your heart in ways that are towards truth, that are towards love, that make all the difference for me. That's what a biblical worldview is about. It's about orienting your mind and your heart towards what is true and doing the very best to work that out in real ways.